Dressed in trim navy blue and carrying her little black bag, the Victorian order nurse is a familiar and welcome caller in many Canadian homes. In a single year, she and her sisters make about 800,000 calls. To those who are ill at home, a Victorian order nurse brings high-skilled care and warm, sympathetic presence. In addition, she takes time to teach both patient and family the fundamentals of healthful living. Many people suffering from infirmities such as heart disease, diabetes, cancer, rheumatism, or arthritis are often happier at home, yet their families cannot assume entire responsibility for their care. The supervision of such patients by a Victorian order nurse has proved a great boon to both the family and the physician. Members of the family are shown how to perform various services for the patients and thus to assist in their care and well-being. In all cases, the Victorian order nurse works under the supervision of the family physician. Notes on the patient's condition are left in the home for the physician, and any significant symptoms are reported to him by telephone. Many a young mother has reason to remember the visits of a Victorian order nurse. A complete maternity service is offered. Instruction is given before the baby arrives, and if the baby is born at home, a Victorian order nurse will be in attendance. The nurse has a personal interest in both the mother and the child. After the arrival, the nurse continues her calls and keeps a careful check on the progress of the baby. As soon as the mother is able, she takes over the complete care of her child under the watchful eye of the nurse. The Victorian order nurse must have public health preparation in her training. From specialists in the field of public health, she learns the cause and control of disease and studies the community resources. Everyone with whom she comes in contact stands to gain from her instruction in healthful living. She must be equipped to meet practically every type of emergency. To help overcome a shortage of public health nurses, a period of instruction introductory to Victorian order nursing is given to graduate registered nurses interested in public health nursing but untrained in this field. The course is of 2 months' duration and is given by various Victorian order branches. Besides regular nursing practices, she must become familiar with the contents of the black bag. She must be resourceful, often improvising with materials found in the home, for example, using clothes pegs for tweezers and newspapers for bags. Most important of all, she must know how to instruct the patient and the family in continuing the treatment. Following this orientation period, these young women work under supervision for a year, then enter university to study public health nursing under the benefits of a scholarship from the Victorian Order. Scholarships are also offered to nurses who wish to take more advanced studies in public health nursing. The young nurse, fresh from hospital, frequently accompanies a Victorian order nurse to observe visiting nursing. This experience gives her a fuller realization of the circumstances under which her patients live and the facilities available for their care at home. She observes the experienced nurse at work and soon becomes eager and anxious to test her own skill and knowledge. Hers is a noble tradition and a proud heritage. No wonder 400 Victorian Order nurses continue to carry that heritage high.